In this video, we will discuss assignment problem. The problem says that you are the head of an organization and you have to assign jobs to the people. So you have n people working under you and you have n jobs that are to be done by these people. So total number of people working for you are n and the total number of jobs that you have is n as well. So each person has to do exactly one job and each job has to be done by exactly one person. So that means that every person will be doing exactly one job and each person has his own capacity. So the capacity of every person has been given in terms of time taken to do a particular job. So your task is to assign the jobs to the persons in such a way such that the total time taken is minimum possible. And a job can be assigned to only one person and a person can only do one job. So basically one person will be doing just one job. So you'll be given this array. So suppose n is equal to 2. So you'll be given this array of size 4. And similarly, if suppose n is equal to 3, so you'll be given this array which is of size 9. So basically it will indicate a 2D matrix. So let us try and understand this with the help of an example. Suppose that we have been given the data. Like let's say we have been given 8. Then we have been given 26. Then we have been given 17. We have been given 11. All this will be given in an array, but I'm making this as a 2D grid. So suppose we have been given 13. Suppose we have 28. Suppose another value we have 4. Suppose another value we have 26. Suppose we have another value 28. We have another value is 19. We have another value 18. Let's say 15 is another value. Then in the last row we have 19, 26. Then we have 24. And then we have 10. Okay. So if these values are given to us, so what we will first of all do is, we'll first of all take the minimum of every row and subtract the row. Okay. So what we will do is, we'll first of all do row transformation, right? We'll do row transformation. And when we do the row transformation, so first of all, we'll take the minimum value of this row, like it is 8. So we'll subtract every value with 8. So it will become 0, right? Then this becomes 18. Then the next value is 9. Then this will be 3. 11 minus 8 will be 3. Then this would be 9. This would be 24. This would be 0. Like when I take the minimum value as 4. Then this would be 0. Then this would be 22. Then this value, next value will be 3 if I take 15 as the minimum. So next value will be 13. Another value would be 4. 3. And here I'll write 0. Similarly, 10 will be the negative, like minimum value. So I'll take 9, then it would be 16, 14, and then 0. Okay. This is what we'll do in the row transformation. After the row transformation, we'll also do the column transformation. So you can understand that in the row transformation, we were taking the minimum of every row and subtracting that minimum from the current row. So here also we'll take the minimum of every column and subtract. So if we subtract 0, so the column remains the same. So 0, 9. And then 13 and then 9 is what we have. After this part is done, so what we have here is, we will have this as minimum will be 4. So here what we'll have is, we'll have 14, then we'll have 20, then we'll have 0, and then we'll have 12. After this, the minimum here will be 0. So here the row, the column will remain the same. So it will be 9, 0, 3, 14. And then next time also the minimum of the next column, last column will also be 0. So nothing will change. So it would be 0. Like let us make this as 0 correctly. Okay. This would be 0. This would be 0 and this would be 0. Then after we have done the column transformation. So what we will try and figure out is, in this after doing the column transformation, we'll try and figure out that which of the rows has 0. So only one 0. So this row has only one 0. Okay. So in that case, what we'll do is, we'll cancel all the elements in this particular column. So we'll cancel all these elements. Then we'll consider the next row. So I can see that in this row, I have a 0, right? I have 0. So if I have 0, so what does it mean? It means that I can cancel this particular row as well. So I'll cancel this particular row as well. Then I will check for the next. So after this, I check. So the third row is having two zeros. Okay. So I cannot consider it. Then the last row is having only one 0. Okay. So I'll consider it and cancel rest of the elements. Now, what does this indicate? This indicates that this 0 that I had in the third row, I had two zeros. But now there is only one 0 because this 0 gets eliminated. So I can say that I can choose this one. Okay. I can choose this 0. and I can eliminate rest of the elements. Okay, so this will be the order in which I'll be choosing. So wherever I have got this zero, like this zero, then this zero, and then this zero, and then this zero, all these places where I have marked as zero, now I'll be taking these values. So let us see that I'll be taking what values. So first of all, I'll be taking this value. So what is this value? If I look at the diagram, so it is nothing but 8. So that will be 8. Okay. Then the next value here would be what? The next value that I would take is this value, that is I think 19. Okay. So I'll take 19. Then the next value is this one in the third column. So the next value is 0 here. So let's see what is the corresponding value. It is 4. So I'll take this 4. Then the next value here is 0. So let's check out what is the last value. Last value is nothing but 10. So I'll take 10. Once I take this value and I add them up, so this will give me the minimum cost. Okay. This will be my minimum cost or minimum time, you can say. Now, what we can understand here is, basically what is happening is, if we consider the person 1, okay, if we consider the worker 1, so machine 1 will be taken care of by the worker 1. And if we observe further, so the machine, which is machine number for us, the machine number 2 will be taken off care by worker 3. Why? How? So let us see this part. So machine number 2 is taken care of by worker number 3. Then the machine 3 is taken care of by the worker 2. And you can see last that machine 4 is taken care of by the worker 4. Okay. So this is how we'll be taking place. And the cost will be minimum. This cost will be minimum possible. And this is nothing but the Hungarian algorithm. But here what we observe, like why did we do so? Because the number of lines that we were getting, okay, we have to do what? We have to draw minimum number of horizontal and vertical lines to cover all the zeros, right? What we did was, we drawed the minimum number of horizontal and vertical lines, okay, to cover all the zeros, right? To cover all the zeros. And in this way, we got it. But here in this case, what happened was, we were able to get the number of lines, the number of vertical lines here was equal to the number of rows that was given to us. So in this case, we can get the answer. But there will be some cases where we will not get the answer. So let us try and understand when we will not directly get the answer and we have to do some other things as well. So let us suppose that we have been given another case like 1500. Then another thing is 4000 and then 4500. Then let's say another case is 2000. Then we have been given 6000. Then we have been given 3500. Then we have been given 200. Let's say we have been given 2000. Then what we have been given is, let's say we have been given, like here we have been given 4000. Then we have been given 2500. Okay. So first of all, we will perform the row transformation as we discussed. So if we perform the row transformation on this given data, so the minimum of this row is this, and this row is this. So first row minimum is 1500, so we'll subtract 1500 from everyone. So it will become 2500, then this would be nothing but 3000, okay, then 0, then we'll have 4000, then we'll have 1500, then we'll have 0 here, we'll have 2000, and we'll have 500 here, okay, after doing the row wise transformation. After we have done the row wise transformation, so what we would do is, we would now consider the column wise transformation. So we'll choose the minimum in every row, okay, every column. So this will be 0, this will be 0, this will be 0. The minimum here is 2000, so I'll choose this, and this becomes 500, this becomes 1500, and this is 0. Then what happens, this value, if I talk about, so this value, like here the minimum would be nothing but 500. So I'll subtract it. So this would be 0. Then this would be 1000. Okay. Then this would become what? This would become nothing but 2500. Okay. That is how we have done the column transformation. Now if we, after doing the column transformation, if we try to cover, if we try to make horizontal and vertical lines in such a way that we can cover all the zeros. So we can see here that in just two horizontal, like in just two lines, we are able to cover all the zeros, right? And that is not equal to n, because 2 is not equal to n, because n was what? N was given to me here as 3. So since n value is 3, the number of rows, or you can say the number of columns, is 3 here. So we can basically understand that we are not able to get this. So if we do not get this part, so in this case, what we will do is, we will basically check that what is the minimum value in the uncovered columns, right? In the uncovered rows. So the minimum value in the uncovered row is 500. So we'll subtract every value from this 500. And once we do that, so what we'll get is, after this, we'll get the transformation as minus 500, then it would be 0 here, then it would be 0 here, 0 here. So we'll do it with every uncovered row. Okay. So now this would be what? This would be nothing but, like, if I take this part, so this would be nothing but 0, then this would be for 1500, this would be 2000, and this would be nothing but 1000. Now, once this much computation has been done, so what we need to do here is, we need to again traverse. And what we will now be doing is, after we get this part, so we will simply say that now in the covered part, whichever is the minimum value, we can add it. So after we do this transformation, so it would become 0. This would also become nothing but 0. Okay. So this would be 0. Then we'll add 500 here. This would be 0. This would be 0. Okay. This value will be 0. This value will be 2000. This value will be 1500. And this value will be nothing but 500. So I have added the value minus 500 to the rows, like to the covered part, right? After we have done this, so we get this particular data. Once we get this particular data, so what we can do with it is, we can try and choose the zeros, right? We can try and choose those rows that have zeros. So this row has just one zero. So I'll cancel this part, okay? Then what is the next? Is there any other row that is having only one zero? Yes. Now this row has just one zero. So I'll cancel the rest of the part. Now this row has only one zero. So third row has only one zero. So I'll consider this, right? So this element and this element is what I'm considering. So if I see what are the actual values of these, so I can see that now my n is what? Now the number of lines that I've drawn is equal to nothing but n, that is nothing but 3. So now I can take these values and you can understand that I'm having 3 values, right? I can determine that worker 1 will be working on which machine, on which machine the worker 2 will be working, and on which machine the worker 3 will be working. So this is how the Hungarian algorithm works. So let's see the values. So the corresponding values that I can see is, like, the first value seems to be 2000, second value is 4000, so the first value is nothing but 2000, second value is nothing but 4000, and the third value that we can observe is 2500. Okay, so once we add these values up, so the minimum that we can get is 8500. That is the cost that we can get. Okay, so that is what we do in Hungarian algorithm. First of all, we try and do the row and column wise transformations. If after doing the row and the column wise transformations, if we get the number of is equal to n, then we simply do what? We simply print, we simply store our answer and return it. Otherwise, we do some more modifications. So this is what we have to do. Now let us quickly check out the code. So first of all, what we'll have is, we'll have n, and we'll do what? We'll make our 2D, like, since we have been given this particular array. So first of all, from this given array, first of all, we'll make our cost 2D grid. Okay, we'll make a 2D grid that will consist of the cost. And then since we are using a minus 1 here, so in the end, we need to multiply minus 1 to our answer, and we'll apply the Hungarian algorithm, Hungarian function. So what we will do is, first of all, we'll try to find the optimal weight. Okay, then the number of vertices in the current matching. So since this will be a graph problem, okay, so what we will do here is, In the augment function, we'll perform the basic steps, that is the row and the column transformation functions. So let us check column transformation functions. So let us check that out quickly, how we'll be doing that. So what we'll be first of all doing is, we'll say that if the match is equal to n, then we'll simply return. Otherwise, what we would do is, we would say that initially we'll mark the set s and the variable, we'll mark the array s and t as nothing but false, and after doing this, we'll try to find the root of our tree. Then we'll initialize the array. Okay, after this part is done, so we will try to build this particular tree with the BFS part. Okay, because we have to do the traversals. Now in this function, what we will try to do is, we'll try to, if the path is not found, then we'll try to improve the labeling, as we have already discussed. Okay, so that is what we are trying to do. And whenever we find a match, so we'll increment our match from this particular function. And if this will be a kind of recursive function in nature. And what we'll be doing is, If we get the maximum matches as n, then we can simply return from it. Otherwise, we can continue. Okay? So, we are using this addToTree function. Another function that we'll be using is updateLabels. So, this is how we'll be overall performing this particular algorithm. And this is a very standard algorithm. And it is rarely asked in companies. So, it is having the time complexity as order of n cube. And the space complexity will be nothing but order of n square, because we'll be using a 2D grid for this. Thank you for watching this video.